The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hi students, let us start this session by a beautiful quote of our famous person who has shown his excellence as a statesman, spokesperson, scientist, missileman, president, etc. Hope you got the person, right? Yes, our beloved human lover, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam sir. All of us do not have equal talent, but all of us have an equal opportunity to develop our talents. This is best opportunity for a start. Don't while away the time uselessly. Make use of it in a most effective way. This is the time. Grab it and make it fruitful. Okay, my dear children? Now, let us practice some problems related to the chapter area. Let's do a problem. In the picture below, the side AC of the triangle ABC is extended to D by adding the length of the side CB. Then the line through C parallel to DB is drawn to meet AB at E. First sub-question, prove that CE bisects angle C. Here we have to prove this line bisect angle C, that is angle ACE is equal to angle BCE, right? First consider triangle BCD. Here the same measurement extended the line from the point C, right? So this triangle, these two sides are equal. So this triangle is an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle, angle opposite to equal sides are equal. You have already studied in 8th standard, right? So here angle CDB is equal to angle DBC, right? That is angle CDB is equal to angle DBC. Angle opposite to equal sides are equal. Mark it as equation 1. Next, here the given condition, the lines CE and DB are parallel. CE, DB. Cut by a third line CB. Make angle DBC and angle BCE. These angles are alternate angles. Alternate angles are equal, right? That is angle DBC is equal to angle BCE. Alternate angles mark it as equation 2. Right? Next, the parallel line CE and DB cut by a third line AD make angle ACE and angle CDB. These angles are corresponding angles are equal, right? That is, angle CDB is equal to angle ACE. Corresponding angles are equal. Mark it as equation 3. From equation 1, equation 2, equation 3 and equation 3, we get angle CDB is equal to angle DBC. DBC is equal to angle BCE. This is equal to angle ACE. Right? So, angle ACE is equal to angle BCE. So, here angle ACE is equal to angle BCE. Therefore, CE bisects angle C. Is it clear, children? Let us do another question. Describe how this can be used to divide an 8 cm long line in the ratio 4:5. Let us construct a figure which is very similar to the above one. Let me draw a line of length 8 cm. This line is 8 cm. Mark the end points as A and B. Take a measure of length 4 cm in your scale. Place the tip of the compass on A and draw an arc of length 4 cm. Again, take a measure of length 5 cm in your scale. Keeping the tip of the compass on B and draw an arc of length 5 cm. Name the intersecting point as C. Now join A and B to C. Here BC is of length 5 cm with the same measurement we are going to extend a line from point C. This is 5 cm. Draw a line of length 5 cm. Named as D. 5 cm. Join the points B and D. Join B and D. A line should be drawn parallel to BD. How? From the point C. Keep this scale in a vertical position. Keep the set square like this. Slide the set square slowly till it reaches C. Draw a line from C to line AB. Now we can see that the line 8 cm is divided in the ratio 4:5. Is it clear, children? There is a homework for you. Page number 21, question number 5, sub question 3. That is also very similar to this. Let us solve a problem. In the figure, the diagonals of a quadrilateral split it into four triangles. The areas of three of them are shown in the picture. Calculate the area of the whole quadrilateral. Here, in the last class, we have learned a line from the vertex of a triangle divides the opposite side and the areas of the triangle in the same ratio. Right? Here, in triangle ACD, the line DE is drawn from D to AC. So here the ratio of these sides AE is to EC. Ratio of the sides AE is to EC. This is equal to ratio of the areas of these two triangles. Right? So here area of triangle AED is to area of triangle CED. Right? This is equal to area of triangle AED is 60 cm square is to area of triangle CED is 30 cm square. This is equal to 2:1. Mark it as equation 1. AD is equal 2:1. AD is equal to 2:1. Next, in triangle ACB, AC, the sides AE is to EC equal, AE is to EC is equal to the ratio of the areas of these two triangles, that is area of triangle AEB is to area of triangle CEB. Right? Here, from equation 1, AE is to EC is equal to 2 is to 1. Right? So here, AE is to EC is equal to 2 is to 1. This is equal to area of triangle AEB. Area of triangle AEB is to area of triangle CEB is 40 centimeter square. 2 is to 1. This can be written as 2 by 1 is equal to area of triangle AEB divided by 40. Cross multiply. 2 into 40 is equal to area of triangle AEB into 1. This is equal to area of triangle AEB is equal to 2 into 40, 80 centimeter square. Right? So, this is equal to 80 centimeter square. Next, we have to calculate the area of quadrilateral ABCD. Area of quadrilateral ABCD is equal to 80 centimeter square plus 40 centimeter square plus 30 centimeter square plus 60 centimeter square. This is equal to 210 centimeter square. Is it clear, children? Let us do another problem. In the picture, the horizontal lines at the top and bottom are parallel. Prove that the yellow and red are of the same area. Here, in triangle ABC and ABD, with the same base and third vertex on a line parallel to the base have the same area. Right? So here, area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle ABD. Right? Here, area of triangle ABE is a common part of these two triangles. Removing this common part, that is triangle, area of triangle, area of triangle AEB, we get what? Area of triangle ACE is equal to area of triangle BDE. So here the yellow part and red parts are equal. That is area of triangle ACE is equal to area of triangle BDE. Is it clear, children? Let's do another problem. In the figure, The diagonals of a trapezium split it into four triangles. The area of the yellow triangle is 10 square centimeters and the area of the green triangle is 20 square centimeters. What is the area of the whole trapezium? Here, the quadrilateral ABCD is a trapezium. The sides AB and DC are parallel. So here, area of triangle ABD and ABC have the same area. In triangle ABD and triangle ABC with the same base and third vertex on a line parallel to the base with the same area. So area of triangle ABD is equal to area of triangle ABC. Same base and third vertex parallel to base. Parallel to the base. Right? So here, area of triangle ABD is equal to area of triangle ABE plus area of triangle AED. This is equal to area of triangle ABE is 20 plus area of triangle AED is 10. 20 plus 10 is equal to 30 centimeter square is area of triangle ABD. Right? Next, area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle ABE plus area of triangle BEC. Right? These two triangles sum is area of triangle ABC. Here, area of triangle ABD is equal to area of triangle ABC. Area of triangle ABD is 30 centimeter square. So here, area of triangle AB is also 30 centimeter square. 30 is equal to area of triangle AB is 20 plus area of triangle BEC. This is area of triangle BEC is equal to 30 is 20 change to right side minus 20. This is equal to 10 centimeter square. Here, area of triangle BEC is 10 centimeter square. Right? A line drawn from vertex of the triangle divides the length of the opposite side and the areas of the triangle in the same ratio. From triangle ABC, a line BE drawn from B to AC. Here, the ratio of the sides is AE is to EC is equal to ratio of the areas of these two triangles. Right? That is area of triangle ABE plus is to area of triangle BEC. this is equal to 20:10, this is equal to 2:1. Is it clear, children? Next, we have to find the area of triangle CED. From triangle ACD, a line DE drawn from D to AC. The ratio of the sides AE is to EC is equal to the ratio of the areas of these two triangles. So, area of triangle AED is to area of triangle CED. Here, AE is to EC is equal to 2:1. So 2:1 is equal to area of triangle AED is 10 is to area of triangle CED. This can be written as 2/1 is equal to 10/ area of triangle CED. Cross multiply 2 into area of triangle CED is equal to 10 into 1, right? Here area of triangle CED is equal to, this two change to right side, 10 into 1/2, this is equal to 5 cm². Here area of triangle CED is 5 cm². Next we have to find the area of the whole trapezium. Area of trapezium ABCD is equal to 20 + 10 + 5 + 10 is equal to 30, 40, 45 cm². So area of the whole trapezium ABCD is equal to 45 cm². Is it clear, children? Let us solve another problem. The picture below shows a trapezium divided into 4 parts by the diagonals. The area of the blue triangle is 4 square cm and the area of the green triangle is 9 square cm. What is the total area of the trapezium? Here, ABCD is a trapezium. The sides AB and DC are parallel. So, triangle ABD and triangle ABC with the same base and third vertex parallel to the base have the same area, right? That is, area of triangle ABD is equal to area of triangle ABC. Here, area of triangle ABE is common part of these two triangles. Removing this part, we get these two triangles' areas equal, right? That is, area of triangle AED is equal to area of triangle BEC. Take this area is x centimeter square. Area of triangle BEC is also x centimeter square. Right? So this is equal to x. Next, a line drawn from the vertex of the triangle divides the length of the opposite side and the areas of the triangle in the same ratio. So here, in triangle ACD, ratio of the sides AE is to EC is equal to ratio of the areas. Area of triangle AED is to area of triangle CED. This is equal to x is to 4. AE is to EC is equal to x is to 4. Mark it as 1. Next, in triangle A, C, B, a line BE drawn from B to AC divides the opposite side. Ratio of the opposite side AE is to EC is equal to ratio of the areas of these two triangles. That is area of triangle AED is to area of triangle BEC. That is AE is to EC is equal to 9 is to x. Mark it as 2. Left side is equal, so we have to equate right side, right? That is from equation 1 and 2 we get x is to 4 is equal to 9 is to x. This can be written as x by 4 is equal to 9 by x. Cross multiply, we get x into x is equal to 9 into 4. X into x, x square is equal to 9 into 4, 36. X is equal to root 36 is equal to 6. So x is 6 centimeter square. That is, here x is area of triangle AED and area of triangle BEC. Area of the trapezium ABCD is equal to 9 plus, here area of triangle BEC is 6 plus 4 plus area of triangle AED is 6. This is equal to 25 centimeter square. The area of the trapezium ABCD is 25 centimeter square. Is it clear, children? Now let us recall what we learned in the chapter. First, all triangles with the same base and area have their third vertex on a line parallel to the base. Conversely, all triangles the same base and the third vertex on a line parallel to the base have the same area. Next, the method of drawing triangle equal in area to that of a quadrilateral. Step 1. Draw the quadrilateral ABCD and draw its diagonal BD. Step 2. Draw a line passing through C and parallel to the diagonal BD. This line meet AB extended at E. Draw DE. We get area of quadrilateral ABCD is equal to area of triangle AED. Next, draw a pentagon and draw a triangle equal in area to that of the pentagon. Step 1. Draw the pentagon ABCD. Divide it into a quadrilateral and a triangle by drawing the diagonal BD. Step 2. Draw a line through C and parallel to BD. This line meets AB extended at F. Draw DF. Step 3. Draw the diagonal AD. Draw a line through E and parallel to AD. This line meets FA extended at G. Draw DG. So we get area of pentagon ABCDE is equal to area of triangle GFD. Next, a line from the vertex of a triangle divides the length of the opposite side and the area of the triangle in the same ratio. Next, in any triangle, the bisector of an angle divides the opposite side in the ratio of the sides of the angle. We have completed this chapter. We will meet at the earliest. Thank you.